Good morning. Thank you for being with us. We are heading straight down the path of 2022, and we're talking all about our resolutions. People trying to be more healthy. Speaking of health, I finally got boosted this week. Took a long time to get my appointment, but I got it. I first received the Johnson & Johnson shot and was told to get the Moderna jab because it works best with my original. We'll see. No side effects so far, just a sore arm. But now that many of us are boosted, we are turning to other health-conscious efforts. Eat better, check. Work out, trying. Drink less, check. But for me, it's not all about getting skinny anymore. Ever since having kids, my body has changed. It happens, it's not bad, but it does require different things than it did before. Because, you know, as we get older, we have to take better care of our bodies. They demand it or they won't work right. So my new year resolution is to just try and feed myself better things, lose weight for health purposes only, and maybe to fit into my old clothes because I don't want to go buy new clothes. But if I were going to buy a few new items to update my wardrobe or even update old outfits, there's only one person I would turn to for advice. And that is New Day stylist Darcy Camden. Hey, happy new year, my friend.
Happy New Year, my friend.
Oh, my gosh. So you've got some great style resolutions in the new year. They aren't all talk, but you back them with some actual steps that we can all follow.
I think it's important to have goals and then action steps to achieve those goals.
All right.
So a lot of times we think having a style transformation happens in one very dramatic day of shopping and buying a lot of things. Mm. And really, sometimes that's the case, but it can also happen really slowly and evolve over the course of the year, taking little actions every month.
All right, so let's talk about these goals. Goal number one, rediscover your personal style.
This is what I'm hearing from everybody, because after almost 2 years in the pandemic of wearing sweatpants and hardly leaving the house, I think a lot of us feel really disconnected from fashion just in general. So you don't even know where to start when it comes to style. So the best action step to take is to subscribe to a fashion magazine.
Okay.
I love InStyle. A subscription for the year is under $20. And every month, it's just like getting a little treat in the mail.
I like that.
And how
that.
How I read a fashion magazine, I read the stories, but then I take a Sharpie and I go through and I circle everything that feels interesting
like
or I just
that.
Like it.
That's clever.
And I cross out anything that I don't like.
Okay.
And it just makes me feel like I've got a handle on it.
I like that. I used to love that Lucky magazine. Did y'all have that one? They don't make it anymore.
Me too.
I love Lucky.
I miss that one.
I know. I do too. All right. Number two, break out of a style rut.
My client Nadine said this was her number one resolution. And I think that being in a style rut means you shop at the same stores all the time and you buy the same stuff, like another black cardigan. And so the action step I want you to take, if this is your goal for 2022, is to try one totally new thing every time you go shopping. Just grab something that is a different color, something you've never tried. If you're not confident picking something, ask a salesperson to grab something for you.
Yeah.
Here's the key. You don't have to buy it. You just have to try it.
Okay.
This is about getting used to trying something on that's outside of your comfort zone. Do this every time you shop, and I promise, eventually you will break out of your rut.
See, Darcy, that's why I love that clothing rental company I use, Armoire. I can try different things without committing to buying them. So I think that's fun. All right. Goal number three, wear more of what you already own.
So the action for this is I call it merchandising your closet. And this is an action that I learned from retail stores. I spend a lot of time in stores, and what stores do with their clothing is they move it around almost daily. And I've been really inspired in the pandemic because, you know, stores have not been getting as much new merchandise as I think they were hoping just because of supply chain issues.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's really been interesting to watch them work with the same merchandise and just move it around to make it feel fresh and new. And this is something that we can use in our own home closets, because I think we tend to buy a shirt, put it in the closet, it stays in the corner, it lives there forever, and sometimes you even forget what you have in there. So once a quarter, take everything out and just put it back in a different place.
I like
sweaters
that.
Sweaters were here, now they're over there.
Switch
jeans
it around.
Were folded, now they're hanging.
Okay, I like that's a good
you
idea.
You will feel,
You helped me do that actually once. And I appreciated that, and that's such a good tip. Number four, though, is break away from fast fashion. I am guilty of this.
I know, it's so tempting because the prices are so enticing.
Mm-hmm.
But the action here that I want everyone to take is to shop local. Visit your local fashion boutiques. Start in your city, in your neighborhood. Maybe invite a girlfriend to go with you. Make a goal once a month, you visit a new local boutique. My girlfriend Sydney calls these fashion field trips, and we try to go to a new place as often as we can.
Okay, can you take me on the next fashion field trip? Because I'm here for it. You and Sydney?
Yes, I would love to. Let's go on a fashion field trip.
All right, goal number five, get back to real clothes again. What does that mean?
This means getting out of the sweatpants and the yoga pants that we've all been living in. And it's important to sort of think about why we like sweatpants, because they're comfortable and because they're easy and because it's just a simple outfit combination.
Yeah.
So I think that to get out of the sweatpants, you really need to replace that with a new weekday uniform.
All right.
So I would look on Pinterest and I would find an easy outfit formula. Maybe it's jeans and a sweater and cute booties.
Okay.
Take a screenshot of it, take it to a store, show a salesperson and say, can you help me find a look
That's
like
a great
this?
Idea, Dars. I love it. Okay, last goal, number six, we only about 45 seconds, stop impulse shopping online. Apparently this is your resolution.
This is my New Year's resolution. I have a real problem scanning Instagram or clicking on online ads and just buying right there. Sometimes things show up at my house and I forgot I even bought it. It's gotten bad. So I am instituting 48-hour wait rule for myself. I can put it in the cart, I can save the link, but I'm not allowed to buy it for 2 days. I'm guessing that I'm gonna forget about most things after 1 day, so I'm hoping this will save me some money, and I'll have to report back to you on how it goes.
I am excited to hear about this. Darcy, thank you so much. Such great tips. We're always grateful for you. Happy New Year again.
Happy New Year.